Hi, I'm Marcos with Costa Farms, and this is the third part in our four-part series on plant care for beginners. Plant beginners care guide for beginners on keeping plants alive. Today, we're going to talk about fertilizing. Now, a lot of people don't really understand how often to fertilize, how much fertilizer to put, what fertilizer is really doing. A lot of people think that fertilizer's role is to provide food for your plant, like your plants eat the fertilizer, but that's not entirely true. Plants eat sunlight, essentially, through photosynthesis, and what fertilizer is more similar to is taking vitamins. So think of like your one a day or your Flintstones chewables, the things that are extra. So just like how if you don't take your vitamins, you won't grow leaves, plants are the same way. And so you might be thinking, well, do plants need fertilizer to live? And the answer is no. So I hope this has been a helpful video. Please keep a lookout for other series to come, but that's about it for this. Okay, fine. There's a little bit more to this. All right, so at least not for the first year or two, but even then, adding fertilizer can help your plants thrive instead of survive. Giving your plant fertilizer can give it that extra little boost to keep growing much faster than it would otherwise. It gives them that sexy green. You know, the green that your friends come over and say, wow, how's your plant so healthy? And you just say, oh, I don't know, I'm just giving it light and water. Fertilizer. So, how often should you fertilize? And like with everything plants, the answer is, it depends. Firstly, how much do you want your plant to grow? The more fertilizer you give, the faster your plant's gonna grow to a point. Once you give it too much, then you could start damaging your plant, and we're gonna get into that in a minute. It's also gonna depend on what kind of fertilizer you're using. They're all formulated a little bit differently, and they're designed to be applied at different times. Some monthly, some every time you water, and some every 6 months. You really need to be aware of what kind of product you're using before you put it on your plant. And there are two main kinds of fertilizer. You have your water-soluble and you have your timed release. Water-soluble, which literally just means dissolves in water. Soluble, dissolve, that's the same root for you Latin and or Greek geeks. So water-soluble, they come in powder or in liquid and you just mix it into the water that you're using to water your plants. And it gives it just a big old blast of nutrients. Think of like a 90s commercial. Then the other kind is your timed release. And this is usually either granules or sometimes it'll come in a little stick that you put into the soil and it will slowly give nutrients over weeks or months. The difference between these is essentially the difference between having a whole bunch of little meals throughout the day, like, you know, those people who have six small meals versus these people who will go all day without eating and then just have one big dinner. They're both valid, they both work. It's really down to personal preference. Just make sure that whatever fertilizer you use, it does say for indoor plants. There's a big difference between some of the ones we use outdoors and the things designed for inside. So that brings us to analysis. If you ever look at your bag or your box of fertilizer, there's gonna be three numbers there. Those numbers are referring to how much of each sort of macro or key nutrient is in a serving size of your fertilizer. And they refer to nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. So it's your NPK analysis. And an easy way to remember that is that nitrogen starts with an N, phosphorus starts with a P, and potassium starts with also a P. And periodic table, all of that, you know, K is potassium, there's reasons for it that are sciencey and Latin-based, I think. So each of these three does something a little bit different, and together the ratio of them will indicate what your fertilizer was designed to do. Nitrogen focuses on stem and leaf growth. It makes your plant essentially look taller, look prettier, and that's one to really look out for houseplants specifically. Phosphorus is a general all-arounder, but high amounts of phosphorus usually indicate that it is a fertilizer that's designed for blooms and flowers most of the time, because it does help that one more than the other two do. Potassium has a reputation of helping root growth more than anything else. So when you are looking for a fertilizer, what we recommend is going for one that's either very balanced with all three numbers being the same, or that nitrogen, that first number, is a little higher than the other two. And so there's a really popular houseplant fertilizer that's out on the market, and its formulation is 24-8-16. So that one has most nitrogen, then the least amount phosphorus, and a middle ground, I would say. of potassium. So with fertilizer, the other thing to keep in mind is less can sometimes be more. And it's absolutely possible to put too much fertilizer, and you could end up burning the roots of your plants, making it impossible for your plant to absorb water. This could lead to your plants having stunted growth or ending up with browning around your leaves. So be sure to read the label, make sure that you're doing it as directed. If you're worried you've given your plant too much fertilizer, which again, can happen, take it out of the pot, just flush your soil out, and make sure that you wash all of those nutrient salts out before they can do any damage. When in doubt, you can always use a little less fertilizer than the package recommends. Your plant doesn't need this to live. This is extra. If you're looking at fertilizers and you can't decide between a synthetic and an organic, don't sweat it. There's not a lot of difference between the two. Whatever your personal preference is, if you're just getting into fertilizing, it's recommended that you first start in the summertime or the spring, because these are when your plants are going to be doing the most growing, because they're getting the most light. In that growing is when they're going to utilize all of those extra nutrients the best. If you notice that your plant is growing slower than it has or than expected, especially if it's been in the same soil for a while, then that's a good sign that it's time to fertilize. The other thing is if your plant's leaves are slightly yellowing, especially along the veins, and it's not a sign of the leaf aging, it's more subtle than a dying leaf, then that's another sign that you should start. So I hope you have a better understanding of fertilizer. Again, key to remember that your plants will survive without it, so anything that you add is just an extra boost. Always err on the side of caution and just watch your plant, listen to signs, keep a close eye on it, and don't expect more than it can give you. For more information on all of that, check out links in the description below, and keep an eye out for our next video, which should be about how to repot a plant.